Yes. Yes, Paul. Paul, tuko hapa Buda. Nimekuita tukae kwa kikao. I want us to make a short statement about what's going on social media. Tunajua kwamba as your fan and your friend, I know very well that you are struggling and you are recovering from the current situation you are facing. Sababu ya kufanya hii live coverage na kutoa outside there kwa fans and the Kenyans at large for what you are going through, kwa sababu kuna cases tumesikia ambayo imehappen kwa comedians wa kutoka Churchill. We saw a few weeks ago, few days ago, Kasekase the late alipatikana amefariki kando ya barabara. Sasa nataka uweze kuelezea mafansi wako huko nje ya kwamba ile story iliongelelewa on Monday.
On Monday.
Na Zedi. Yes, na Zedi.
Yeah, first of all, thank you so much, by the way, for reaching out, Ozzy.
Yes,
you're a very close friend that we've been away for a very long time.
Yes, bro.
And the issue that Zedi alisema, nimefanya, nimepata messages mingi sana kwa simu yangu.
Okay.
Na nimepata so many questions, people who are trying to know how I'm doing, fans, my haters, pia wanajaribu kudikejeli, pia ikainikama, pia nenda kujitia kitanzi.
It's normal, yeah.
And for the sake of my fans and the fans who are watching me right now, I would just want to tell them that, first of all, whatever Zedi said about me, chances are it was very true. I have been going through depression for the last 3 years,
yes.
And it has not been a very easy road for me.
Yes.
And wakati when nilikuwa na go through depression, first of all, it started from the church you show in nilikuwa nafanya.
Yeah.
And today I hope that I want just to let it go from my heart, so that niweze kugrow ama niweze kujisamehea na kusamehea watu ambao wanaweza kuwa walinikosea. Nilikuwa nafanya church you show na at some point I felt like we are falling out because of one or two things. First of all, ilikuwa ni point yenye nilitoka hapa hivi, nilipigiwa simu at around 2 a.m. in the morning na nikaambiwa niende mpaka Nakuru. Hiyo show ilikuwa Nakuru on that day.
Yeah.
And when I left here and went all the way to Nakuru at 5 a.m. nilifika huko vo at around hiyo time yenye nilifika, so by the time nilikuwa nakutana na creative director.
Yes.
The creative director kaniuliza, umekaa kufanya nini hapa Nakuru na tulitoka na wasanii? Nikamuliza, I was called at 2 a.m.
Nilikuwa
nimeitwa 2 a.m.
perform.
Yes,
ukafika kwa venue.
Wakaniuliza, umekuja kufanya nini hapa?
Okay, bro. Now nikuulize swali. When you were called to perform show in Mombasa, were you already under depression?
Yes, I was going through depression because first of all, you remember nilikuwa na accident kwa life yangu.
Yeah.
Na hiyo accident, I was the one who was driving. I have to tell the fans right now because there is no need of always hiding it. And
yeah, yeah.
Wanataka pia kujua what happened.
Just a minute. Because there's been rumors. Kuna fans, I've been your fan since way back 2010.
Yes,
when
yes, yes.
When you started.
Yes.
So nakujua sana wewe rafiki yangu, ndio maana nimekuwa na wewe, maana tunafanya hii coverage niweze kufikia wale mafans kama
wale wanataka kujua.
Wako huko nje wanataka kujua kwa sababu depression si jambo rahisi sana kwa wanaume.
So after nili fall out from after we had the accident, I tried to pick myself up.
Okay.
Because you see the current situation ya ma comedian, ukipata mtu ako depressed,
yeah,
wagani definitely the next thing ni suicide.
Venye
imekuwa,
yeah.
Naona, but for me nilikaa hivi chini nikajiambia, right now I have so many people depending on me.
Yeah.
And when I also had the accident, nilianza kuwa depressed, nikaanza kukata maji mbaya sana.
Yeah.
Nilijiingiza kwa matei na I was drowning every day to the level yenye no one could understand me. Because if where I started from my career, nilianzia Churchill Show, and I was trying to pick myself up and just move on.
Yeah.
And those guys were not understanding what I'm trying to do with my life or even to help. Unaona?
Yes.
And nikaona I don't have anyone who I can depend on.
Yes.
So at that point, I went into depression.
Yeah.
And since I had a girlfriend when I looked at my data for over 5 years, I think it was 5 years.
Yes.
That lady also left me.
Okay.
So hiyo ikaongezea into this depression. I remember there are days I would wake up na naangalia hivi, you are waking up from your sleep or your slumber, unaangalia hivi unaona matile za gari. unaona matiles za gari
ukiwa umelala.
Umelala ndio umeamka. Ndio umeamka eh, ndio umeamka. Eh. Kumbe niko kando ya barabara mzae. Kumbe niko kando ya barabara na angalia hivi naona hii ni jam. Hii ni jam watu wanaenda works. You get it?
Umeamka na uko kwa barabara
huko kwa nyumba. Siko kwa nyumba, sikufika kwa hao.
Kwa roadside.
Nili blake.
Angalia tu.
Eh.
The
previous night, nikajipata hapo. There are days in this in my life. There are days in my life penye nimejipata. Bro, unaamka hivi unapigwa makofi na makarao. Na watu wamesimama hapo hivyo nje, unauliza ni nini? Wananiuliza, sikiza tu kidogo, waliniuliza, remember that day? Ilikuwa niliamka, waliniamka, mimi nimeamka from slumber, kaje niliamsha ni makofi. Amka, 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 amka. Na amka hivi nauliza ni nini mbaya naona watu na mauniform. Kumbe ni makarao mzae. Ati kumbe penye nilikuwa jana usiku, nilizua manze. Nikapiga watu mbaya sana. Niko na cases za assault ngapi?
Tano. Out of depression, you don't know what you are doing.
Yes.
You are violent.
I became violent, bro. I became violent. Na hiyo time, I remember pia, na, job imesha kataa. So, sina kazi. Si, nimepoteza relationship.
Yes.
Sawa. Nimepoteza relationship na ndio hii pia najaribu kustruggle ku pick up myself nijue what else can I do? Who is out there for me? Who can help me right now? Because nikijaribu kuambia hata kama watu wenye uliko na trust our feel ni kama wanaweza ku help, then you don't see the reason of even talking to your fans. And that is why fan page yangu hata niliachanaga nayo for a while.
Yeah. For a while. You have not been online.
Yes.
You are nowhere to be seen.
Nowhere to be seen.
WhatsApp.
Yes. I only came to on a story I was ready after someone talked to me akaniambia niaje ndio hii story Zedi anasema hapo vo juu yako, and I won't lie, Zedi, what Zedi said on that show is very true.
It's very true.
Whatever Zedi said on that show about me is very true. Right now where I am in my life, I am at a point penye I'm trying to pick myself up.
You're putting yourself up.
I'm trying to bring myself up. Unaona, because if I'm not the kind of person who gives up easily.
Yes, bro.
If you've seen me performing on stage, you have even seen my hands. My hands were burnt. At some point, I was supposed to die.
Cool, bro.
You get?
God yako na wewe.
God amekuwa na mimi
wakati wote.
Eh.
Okay, what I just want you to do, because I just want this to reach out to your fans,
yes,
and the Kenyans at large. This is what we are doing here. I just wanted, as your brother, a fan, a brother, at the same time, this coverage to reach out there,
yeah,
for Kenyans. Like, I am urging Kenyans and the fans.
Yeah.
You need support. If we can support Paul Wakimani, and I am requesting whoever who can come front to msaidie ndugu yetu hapa, whatever is fighting, it's real. He's our comedian, he has been there. Depression, it's real. It's here, he has confirmed, I'm a PTSD depression. So what we are appealing outside there, whoever mali popote hii itafikia, akwe Mkenya mali yuko, fan wake pali yuko, and we can reach to Paul Wakimani, we help him.
Emotionally. I would really appreciate if someone just,
yes,
every day you just send a positive message to someone when you feel like I'm and a low kidogo.
Encourage him.
Yes, because yeah, we have been through a lot, and if it was a point yenye ilikuwa nafanya nijiue, ni hiyo time. And the second thing yenye ningependa ku address ni ati after the accident is the time penye tulitoka tukazika yeye.
Yeah.
Na kuzika yeye, we came back to Nairobi.
Yes.
And when we came back to Nairobi, I thought that everyone understood that it was an accident. Yeah. Kama kawaida.
Yeah,
sawa, sawa.
Yeah, yeah.
So after like a week or two, the wife called me and alinipigia kaniambia kuna barua yangu anataka kunipatia wife ya yeye. So nikasema sawa sawa, niko na shughuli kidogo nikimaliza na kama. So that day sigeweza kukutana.
Okay.
And then I met her on the second day. On the second day she was serving me a court order.
Court order.
A court order that I am supposed to pay for what for killing her husband.
Aye, the late. Okay.
It is not a lie what Zedi said that Nadaiwa 21 million.
Yes.
And it is not a lie what the bloggers say that Nadaiwa pesa kwa
the family of
from
the
family. Yes.
Yeah.
The family has been in constant. Mimi nimejaribu sana to make things work between me and the family. But on the day yenye nilikuwa naongea na wakili, nilikuja nikasaviwa, wakili alinipigia simu akaniambia kuna barua yako imefika hapa. Na hii barua inasema ati Ayeya was earning 300,000 every month. Unaona.
So they did the calculation.
Yes, so since Ayeye was earning 300 every month and he died at 31, when he's retiring, he's supposed to be retiring at the age of 55.
So they did the maths.
The maths, 300 times 12 times, hiyo miaka yenye mabaki afike 55. Unaona.
Yeah.
Na ukiangalia court charges pia itabaki lazima na shughulikia damages. So roughly it was heading to around 20 million.
Okay.
Which I will say here right now that if at all, since the case is in court,
yeah.
I cannot talk about the case. But what I can share is what I have received.
Yes. That I am in court.
And that is what made me also succumb into deeper into.
So case already iko kotini.
Case iko kotini. Kesi iko kotini, yes.
You have been summoned.
Ni corona imesimamisha ndio maana ikakuwa siwezi size hakuna maskuli za kusizo. Yes. Yes, but the case is in court and on the day yenye, you see, I don't know if I should say the truth or what should I do. But right now, even when Ayeye ndio tulipata accident.
Mm-hmm.
But on the day that unfortunately we lost him, ndio alikuwa amerudi Churchill Show.
Yeah.
Yeah, because there was a point alikuwa amebreak. Unaona baba?
Yeah.
So it is very wrong for even a person mwenye unajua mwenye ana understand the wife. Let me start from the wife.
They were there. You were
not even, yes,
you
she was in the car
on the scene when
she
the
was not in the scene. She was in the car when the accident happened.
Among of the passengers.
She was one of the passengers when the accident happened. Okay. Apparently it was Ayeye who called me to go and pick him up. I was coming from my own show, nimetoka Ngong Road.
Okay. Sawa bro.
And at some point I would really want to retrieve all those phone calls for them to understand, because my fans don't have to see me as a person who can sacrifice a friend.
Yes.
That was a friend, and that is why ever since then nime fall out.
Okay.
But I hope that I will be back.
You will be back, bro. Just say one word to your fans and whoever is going to watch this clip.
Yes.
We are looking forward for their support emotionally,
yes,
spiritually
mliombe sana,
and even financially. We need him back aweze kununua senior smartphone Ayeye anatumia kabambe
bana, wakimani anatumia kabambe hapa man,
sorry, wakimani anatumia kabambe
bana.
So that's from wakimani hapa, so
man,
you have heard it from the horse's mouth. What's going around, it's true. So let's reach him out.
Give yeah. me what all I need is that I have come from so far. So I see your story, and as much as it is depression, yes, I was depressed at the severe depression. I have managed to at least fight it, and I'm still on my way to recovery.
Yes, bro.
Unaona?
You have recovered.
I'm still on my way to recovery.
You can't compare what you have gone through.
Yes.
Pale uko leo.
Oh, unaweza imagine.
Tumeweza kufanya hapa ka interview kidogo hivi.
Yes.
Uweze kufika huko nje.
By the way, just let them know, let the fans know that I'm okay and everything is doing.
We are waiting whoever will want to do something.